Good evening. I'm waiting for a good response or I could go on forever.
Good evening.
There you go. We're so glad that you're here with us, and we're so glad that our children's department is with us, that our youth department is with us, and I want to tell you that they have worked hard. This is their initiative. They wanted to do something to celebrate Christmas that reflected them. And they're going to present to you tonight the story of Christmas, the story of Christ. And I think you're going to be blessed, the message that they bring to you. I just want to read one scripture to you. It's a familiar one. It's out of Isaiah 9, 6 and 7. And just close your eyes and think about this. For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. And that's the message that's going to be brought to you tonight. And I want you to just sit back and enjoy. I'm going to tell you, you know, it's a lot of fun in watching our children present a program to us, whether it's singing or a drama. But beyond that, I want you to see the message that they're presenting to you tonight. The message that is being emphasized this whole season, that Jesus came for you and me. Are you ready? Let's begin.
And it came to pass in those days that a decree... And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men." So it was when the angels had gone away from them into heaven that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told them.
Thank you. Love incarnate, love divine. Star and angels gave the sign. Bow to babe on bended knee, the savior of humanity. Unto us a child is born, he shall reign forevermore. No.
did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels try? When you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak. Baby boy is Lord of all creation. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? This sleeping child you're holding is the great I
tell you what, none of my children were part of this, but I can tell you I couldn't have been more proud of everyone that took part. And Miss Brenda, Miss Sandy, would you come up and just introduce your children here and just give them a little bit of recognition for. And youth, would you come out front as well, and I'd like to give you some recognition. First of all, tell us who the piano solos are. Won't you all take a bow and let everybody know that how much you appreciate being part of this. Amen. You can have your seats. And Miss Erica, would you come up and introduce your youth, please? And Susie, would you wave at everybody so they can see you up there in the sound booth?
Sarah Willett, Kami McGeehee, Kayla Furman,
I want to thank the children's department, the youth department. I can tell you, it couldn't have been a better presentation of the truth of the ages, and that is Jesus came for all of us. I really just want to read one passage out of Isaiah 49, and then we'll say a prayer and close, and invite you to come over. We're going to have some light refreshments over in the Family Life Center. Is it the Family Life Center or the Fellowship Hall? The Fellowship Hall. And so we ask you to join us for that. But earlier I read out of Isaiah 9. To that, right now I want to read out of Isaiah 49. And this is the prophecy about the Son to come. Verse 1 through 6, excuse me. Listen to me, O coastlands, and hearken, you peoples from afar. The Lord called me from the womb, and from the body of my mother he named my name. He made my mouth like a sharp sword, in the shadow of his hand he hid me. He made me a polished arrow, in his quiver he hid me away, and he said to me, you are my servant, Israel, in whom I will be glorified. But I said, I have labored in vain, I have spent my strength for nothing in vanity, yet surely my right is with the Lord, and my recompense with my God. And now the Lord says, who formed me from the womb, to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, and that Israel might be gathered to him. For I am honored in the eyes of the Lord, and my God has become my strength. And he says, it is too light a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and restore the preserved of Israel. But I give you as a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth. And that is the message of the Christmas story. Jesus sent him to be salvation for all the world. Each of us has an opportunity to be forgiven of our sins and to be received into his family as his child. And if you don't know Jesus, I'm so happy for the message that's brought here tonight, emphasizing that Jesus is the reason for the season. But I want you to know it's even more personal than that. And Jesus came for you and for me. And if you don't know Jesus tonight, I would pray that you make it right. There's nothing to prevent you from coming forward and declaring your desire to be a child of God. And if you mean it in your heart, it will happen today, tonight, this moment. No delay, if you mean it. And so if you want to pray on that tonight, we'll have people here to speak to you and to help you understand how easy it is because of what Christ has done for you. Otherwise, I hope that you take this message with you as you go forward towards Sunday. And by the way, we'll have services here at 11 o'clock on Sunday morning. We're not going to have Wednesday services. But on Sunday morning, we're going to have services, and we're going to celebrate the Lord's Supper on Christ's birthday. And we invite you to come be part of that. But in the meantime, take the message that has been presented today, tonight in song and in drama, and realize that Jesus is the reason for the season. Share that message with everyone you know. Someone needs to hear it tonight. Someone needs to hear it tomorrow. Someone needs to hear it this week. Someone needs to hear it before Christmas Day. Amen? Well, let's stand and I'll close this in prayer. And again, we'll make our way over to the fellowship hall for a little bit of refreshment. Father, we thank you for your blessings. Father, it almost sounds trite to say thank you for your son, but Father, we thank you for your son. Father, we thank you for how he has been presented to us through the message of the young ones. Father, we thank you for those that have presented the drama to us to emphasize the person of Jesus. Father, may that message resound and resonate in our minds and hearts. May it be on the tip of our lips, Father, that we might share with others, Father, that the world might indeed be saved. We pray that we might help expand your kingdom this week, Father, with the message of your Son. And it's his name we pray. Amen.